the point of the poem is that I'm comparing us to plants, because obviously if you have a plant and you don't water it, it will die. And that's what humans are like. You know, if we don't water ourselves, if we don't grow, we will die. Not physically necessarily, but, you know, metaphorically, spiritually, financially. If we don't grow, we die.
Can I get some clicks in this season?
word.
We love to hear it. When you're ready,
Upon entering this cold world, fully grown adults from a tightly folded curl, we embark on a journey right from baby boys and girls to school boys and school girls to young adults to the old. No one ever wants to die, but do we ever truly live? They say females give life, but do they really truly give? I say this because I see the young and the old wasting away, rolling smoke and spliffs, and those who have given up jumping off a cliff. I hope you're catching my drift. See, it breaks my heart to say that there are those who want to tell the woman who gave them life that they don't want it no more, simply because they can't take any more, and they feel as though their life has been washed away like the tide on the shore. We didn't ask to be brought into this world, yes, I agree. But here we are, so we might as well make some good memories. Read some books, but not become skullduggeries. How pleasant life is, and you can disagree, but allow me first to take you to the periphery and show you life from a different perspective. We are what I call us in another poem, human plants. You see, someone has sown the seed of life, and from this derived me and you. Nature being our parents fed and watered us and distinguished me from you. But when that sun stops shining, what do we do? Do we say adieu or do we pursue? Well, what you do is up to you, but here's my view. Humans die like plants too. If we don't grow, then others outgrow and take our nutrients. But we must assert our dominance. We mustn't be afraid to grow out of our parents' alignment. Taking risks confirms our existence. Because the fear of death is the end of life and the beginning of survival. In all honesty, that line right there should be in the Bible, because those are worse to follow like Jesus and his 12 disciples. But allow me first to continue with my poetic recital. You see, life isn't just a cycle. Instead, life's the ability to recycle dreams when they die. Learning to say see you soon instead of saying goodbye. No longer being a passerby, but instead people stop when they pass you by and utter the words, this person's living life. You see, it's funny because I have a 7-minute poem on the meaning of life, but I still don't think I found meaning in life. Well, I guess you must first be alive. But in order to live, you must learn how to grow, learn how to reap and learn how to sow, learn how to think, dream and pursue, because there's no point searching for the meaning of life. Because like plants, if we don't grow, we die too.
Hey. word. I haven't got everyone clapping, cheering, driving home, driving wherever you're everyone's at home and at tier four, guys. What can we do? But amazing.
Thank you.
Started off, so my girl said she's going to start off light. In my opinion, that was very, very strong. But got more to hear from her. So everyone, don't worry. If you missed that and you're just tuning in now, don't worry. There's more coming. Don't worry. We started off light. So there's more to come. That's all I'm going to say for now. But I'm going to hit it with some tunes now. So sit back and relax.
I know you're going to dig this. Have you on the SS social?
The story behind it.
All right. So the title of this one is called Every Hair of Me. And it was written around Valentine's Day 2019. And obviously Valentine's Day is about love and loving people and all of that, yada yada.
What's your take on love?
Right. Love is a 2 out of 10.
Oh, okay. Would it recommend?
No, I'm joking. That's another topic for another day. Okay. The poem is about self-love, essentially, you know, and to be able to love someone, you need to first love yourself. And it's about looking for self-love and understanding that, you know, you are worthy of love. And the poem uses hair as a metaphor, and I kind of go through the entire body and talk about different hairs. And each hair represents how much love I have for myself and how much love you should have for yourself too. And we have a lot of hair, so we deserve a lot of love, you know, so yeah. We'll get right into it.
There's gonna be a lot of clicks, and I can tell.
I hope.
I can tell already. Yeah, when you're ready.
All right. every single hair on my body perfectly placed. From the roots of my head down to the vellus hair on my toes. Each night I lay myself to sleep in a bed of hairs. Each hair a rose to count the amount of self-love I've grown. Each petal plucked by others to tell me they love me. They love me not. They love me. They love me not, so I guard my heart, the biggest rose of them all jealously. And you question, why have I built my wall so high only I can climb? But I question, why have you dug your standards low to places I refuse to go? I refuse to allow you to shave me hairless anymore, because growing this love back is such a chore, and if I don't love myself, then I'm not worthy to be loved. Every hair to count the number of boys that don't know how to carry glass because they don't know how to handle a queen. Instead giving the excuse that I'm too talented for them. My talent bruises their ego. My life is figured out whilst they're still figuring theirs out. So they drop me and I've learnt to carry myself, this beautifully broken masterpiece plastered with self-love. I carry myself to heights these boys will never reach. I carry myself to depths these boys will never see. I carry myself to places these boys will never go. I carry myself because if I'm too much of a burden for myself, no one will dare carry me. Every hair damaged from all the heat you've brought to me. Straight and cold waves shaping me to your satisfaction because you don't like the me I brought to my table. But I've learned I don't need to eat in the company of others to enjoy a meal. So be gone with all your images of what I should look like, because when I look in the mirror, I love what I see. I do. The marrying of two entities. I kiss myself, and with that kiss, an influx of self-love made sweet passionate love to every hair on my body. Every ingrown hair from all the shaving. Because a girl shouldn't have hairs in all those places. Causing me to stop in your pursuit because, wait, I haven't shaved. Except for a good two, but the rest not understanding that a forest is where life thrives. Representing femininity in my eyes. So I would rather let it grow. Every eyelash hair to protect my eyes from falsified love entering, because they say love is blind. But with self-love, you don't need to see, because it comes from deep within. So deep that only the bearer can access it. It sticks onto every inch of my skin, gripping onto every hair, covering me in an impenetrable sheet. Nothing beyond its surface matters. Words and actions carry little value, because I love every hair of me.
We've got a lot of clicks. Thank you, thank you. Girl, that wordplay. I don't know if you guys are just tuning in. We've got Sir James in the building. I want you to plug yourself right now. Give yourself an on, you know. Don't even care about it. Just plug yourself shamelessly.
Lol, okay. So you can find me on Instagram at Sir James, SirJVMES. No, Twitter, the same thing. Sir_James. Pretty much, yeah.
She's got a lot of videos, not just what you're hearing now. There's a lot more videos on Instagram for you guys. There's a lot more coming out too.
Stay tuned.
Up and coming. I'm preaching this to the end. Up and coming. And I start already here. Not even just in the making. She's already there.
Man,
She's elite. She's at her level.
Nah, you're gassing me too much.
She's getting You have to be gassed.
Why should I be humble?
Amazing. I have a question for you. Where do you get your inspiration from to be a spoken word artist or a rapper or poet or whatever you want to brand yourself as?
I've always been into rap from a very early age, about the age of 8 or so. You know, so I wrote my first rap and my first poem. I actually still have the physical paper to this day, like 12
selling
years
it on eBay.
Later. No, I'm gonna frame it and I'm gonna hang it up in my house.
Okay.
But yeah, so I fell into rap before I fell into poetry, but it was just me listening to it. I grew up listening to Chip, Lil Wayne, Eminem, the man there. And then secondary school, that's when I got introduced to spoken word. And I was like, "Raw, this is sick." I never considered rapping because I was like, I can't do any of that. But I just enjoyed listening to it.
Yeah.
But the poetry thing was like, "Raw, this is sick," you know, and I really enjoyed reading poetry. So I was like, nah, this sounds wavy. Let me try it out. So then I wrote my first poem in around year 8. You know, my first spoken word piece put on Facebook, because, you know, Facebook wall was popping that day, you know. And like got bare like positive feedback. And I was like, oh, okay, you know.
No hate is out there.
And I wrote another one. I was like, okay. And then I wrote another one. But it was like a lot there was a lot of time in between each one I wrote because it was a hobby. I never thought, oh, let me do this as an actual career kind of thing, you know. And then I came into uni, and fam, windows opened. And then the rap thing came recently, you know. My brother really pushed me into it. At first, I was converting my poetry into rap, which wasn't really working. So I was like, this isn't working. Let me just do poetry. Like, it's not by force, you know. And then once I realized that me as a poet and me as a rapper are two very different people, yeah, then like my flow, my delivery, my writing skills and rap improved steadily, you know. So when you hear me, because we're getting into rap later on, you know, so stay tuned, you'll see that my rap and my poetry is very, very different, very different. But yeah.
I can vouch for that as well. I feel like you're almost two different artists, but you're still the same. But you still come from the same. Like, you can still tell it's your voice, your soul. Mm. But amazing. As usual. And there's more to come. So everyone that's sitting at home.
Pick up DJ Deedz though, you know, cut.
Don't do that. We're not about to do that. Nah.
Nah, man. Wait, he's DJing South still. Come on.
Sorry, we've got more tunes for you guys, as well as more performances. So, lovely show for you guys. Tune in, man. All right, we're gonna go in with a bit of an Afro vibe for you lot. We did the little UK drill, kind of bit of US, and then slowed it down. But take it to Africa, man. Mm. That's where it's popping. That's where everyone's at now. Nige, I'm seeing it popping. So we're taking it to Nige with a bit of burner. So we're just gonna go straight in. Multi-talented.
Yikes.
They're the people that are versatile, that can do everything. We love to see it. Just one trick wonder. You can do everything.
Word.
So explain this one for us. Title, has it got title?
Yeah, it's called Little Light.
Okay.
Yeah.
I always find it hard to like name things. So like if I'm making a mix, I'm always like, what do I call this? I'll ask my sister and she'll come up with some weird names. So how do you find inspiration to, you know, pick out a phrase or a name?
Well, obviously, like with DJing, it's a lot different because you know. But if you're writing, usually there's a phrase or a word that sticks out that encapsulates the entire piece that you've done. Okay. You know, especially if you've written a chorus, usually somewhere in the chorus you will find your title, you know.
So look out for Little Light, guys. That's what we're looking out for. If you don't hear it, then we all know.
I mean, it's not really a chorus for this one, but you know. Yeah.
Okay, so we've got a little rap. And do you want to explain the meaning behind it?
Now, obviously, 2020 is coming to an end.
Amen. Yeah. Amen to that. Please, come to an end.
It's coming to an end. So I just kind of like, I was just doing it for the vibes, you know. I was just writing, I was like, oh, let me just write like some end of year, like outro kind of thing. And then it just ended up being like an entire track. And I was like, oh, you know what, I should maybe post this. Mm. So what you're about to hear, I'm going to drop in a couple days. I haven't decided when, but it will be coming before this year ends, most definitely. First like proper, like full piece rap I'm posting into the universe.
This is an exclusive. You should feel privileged. Capital P privileged. Lord. To be hearing this.
Yeah.
Me, myself, I'm excited.
Ooh. All excited.
I'm back in track for this one as well, guys.
One early morning and I found out that my boy is using. It hurt my heart to see him smile through the pain. It hurt more when I told him that the pain will go away. Cause it never really does. You just learn to look away. And you learn to feel in colour in a world that is grey. Rain, go away, come another day. And when you come, don't come to stay. Cause brother wants to play, but sister wants to play too. And it's hard to help each other when everyone has their problems. They don't tell you that they go through. And Twitter teaches you that you should stay in your own lane. But in this life I've learned that we all have a part to play. And should we be mistaken or should we be led astray? I put my palms together, close my eyes, kneel down and pray. That if you're suffering alone, you see a brighter day. And that your joy is not denied, your joy is delayed. 2020's been a crazy year, man. A lot of people have gone through a lot. Myself included. So I'm blessed to see another day. Daily. Despite the year, I can say it's been a blessing. And God has blessed me so much, I can see these niggas stressing. Would never think to love the pain, but I so refreshing. It made me who I am today. And if I can wish upon a star, I don't know where to even start. I wish my friends go really far, these people really are my heart. I love them big, I love them hard, but if you ever air me, I will bend you like I'm Avatar. And I'm fine like red wine, at night I slow wine, the stars do align. I wait for my time, cause this little light of mine's always gonna shine. This little light of mine's always gonna shine. I'm fine like red wine, at night I slow wine, the stars do align. I wait for my time, cause this little light of mine's always gonna shine. This little light of mine's always gonna shine. What a blessing to be a blessing, man. What a blessing to be a blessing.
Amen.
Bigger things in 2021, man.
Word.
Sir Jvmes in a building.
There we go. Sweet beat, sweet rap, sweet everything.
Sweet indeed, man.
We love to see it. That's Sir Jvmes.
S-I-R-J-V-M-E-S.
Okay, on Instagram, on Twitter, on everything. Everyone hit her up. Everyone follow her.
You know the vibe.
Shout her out. You know, give her love. And if you guys, well, she does commissioned raps as well. Let's plug
it. I do commission, man. So, if you need something in Britain, whether it's for a brand.
Valentine's Day is coming up. Let's talk about that.
I will write your man's a love poem. Oh. He will fall in love with you. He will marry you on the spot.
There we go. But for money, though. For money.
We don't work for free.
We don't work for free.
Too talented for that.
Yeah, that's not what we do. So round of applause in the studio.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Going to round it off with a few little tracks, little old school tracks, just quickly. That's me done for today, guys. DJ Deedz on the beat. DJ Deedz, pass me the aux. Okay, and bookings as well coming. If you want to book me, you know, hit me up, Farida El Gharabli. That's the confusing part. My Instagram is not DJ Deedz.
Are we gonna make it DJ Deedz?
Not gonna lie, there's someone on Instagram. I've DM'd her. Her name is DJ Deedz. She's taken the handle.
Did she respond?
No, I got Ed. So until that happens, we're staying as my name. My name is Farida El Gharabli. It's good curse because it's like the hardest thing to spell as well. FARIDAELGHARABLY. Good luck. If you heard that, you heard that. If you didn't, oh well, sorry. But we've got a little bit of a, this is my favorite song ever.
Oh,
which is a big statement to make.
I think I know what song this is.
Favorite song ever. So don't curse me as well, because I don't care. This is my favorite song. I'm gonna just play it.